I thank you that you get ready to do the impossible in the lives of your people that's in the will of God. I thank you that you get ready to do the impossible, God. The impossible, God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, that's, for the elevation that you're about to give your people, God. The elevation that you're bringing, God. You're bringing them up, God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you that there, your people are going to begin to see their destiny like they have never seen it before. In the name of Jesus. They're going to begin to see their destiny, God, like they never seen their destiny before, God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, for even giving them a mindset to seize their destiny. A mindset to even seize their destiny, God. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you as the church goes up, the congregation goes up. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, for destroying. Thank you, Father God, for destroying guilt, shame, condemnation, hurt, all of these things. I thank you for destroying them, God, and giving your people a new mindset. In the name of Jesus, thank you for giving your people a new mindset to walk in a new integrity, a new strength, God, a new strength right now. In the name of Jesus, we release upon the congregation a new strength and power right now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory in the name of Jesus. Right now, in the name of Jesus, anybody in this ministry sick, I speak healing to come upon them right now, from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet. Right now, I speak the hand of God right now to saturate them from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. I decree and declare sickness die right now in the name of Jesus. Everything that's blocking you from your destiny and your purpose, right now I decree and declare I remove that stumbling block in the name of Jesus. I remove every thought coming up against your mindset for you to make progress in the name of Jesus. I speak right now in the name of Jesus where you will begin to make progress in your purpose and destiny where you have never made before, and take steps that you have never made before into your purpose and your destiny. In the name of Jesus, where nobody will be able to tell you nothing, where you will know what God has done for you, where you will know. I speak right now in the name of Jesus into your womb. I speak into your womb right now, releasing in your womb right now in the name of Jesus, that you will know, hallelujah, and feel the presence and the power of God.
Open up their mindset, God.
Open up their mindset. Drop a seed in their mindset and nurture and water and cultivate that seed in the name of Jesus, where they will begin to just grow, God. Where they will begin to see themselves growing, and they will just begin to grow like they have never grown before. I release it as an apostle in the name of Jesus. I release it up on this church. I release it in here right now. In the name of Jesus, I decree it and declare it, where you will just soar and take off to heights and dimensions where you have never gone before. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you that everything that I accomplished and the ministry, I thank you, God, that it shall come down in this house, God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. And that determination, I speak that into their life, God. That tenacity, that determination to keep moving and to keep growing, God. In the name of Jesus. Kabababashanda. Rekibobomoshata. Kabababasata. In the name of Jesus, that tenacity to keep growing, keep moving. I thank you, God, in the name of Jesus.
And we thank the Lord for being here. We give honor to our leadership. Teresa Cox, we give God praise in her absence. Thank God for my daughter being here with me. It's good to be here. Amen. Thank you, man of God, for allowing us to come and to minister the word of the Lord. We honor you. Bless your congregation. Let us all stand. Let's look to the Lord. How many of you came for a word from the Lord? Amen. So important that when we come to God's house, we come expecting to hear from Him.
Amen.
The power of God flows to the level that you place a demand. Somebody say amen. So we're going to believe God. Grab somebody by the hand. Jesus said, if two of you, there's more than two of us, should agree touching anything that you should ask, it shall be done. Amen. I'm believing God to speak. I sense the anointing coming right now. Father, we thank you. We honor you for this opportunity to minister your word. I call all things into alignment. I bind the powers of darkness. I release your angels. I release your power, your anointing to flow freely in this house. God, I take authority right now. I yield my mind and my thoughts and my tongue to your Holy Spirit. God, grace us today according to your promise. Speak to the hearts of your people. I thank you for the prophetic. I thank you for insight, keenness, and accuracy in the Spirit. Not for my glory, but for your glory. I loose your power right now. I loose your will to be done. In the name of Jesus, God, we stand in agreement, God, right now for a move of your Spirit. Be glorified among us. Move how you want to move. Do what you want to do. Throw your weight around. Somebody needs you. Somebody needs you right now, God. I thank you. I give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise. In the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Clap your hands and give God praise.
Tell somebody, I felt that. I should be. I felt that. Thank God. Grab your Bibles quickly.
We're going to go into the word of the Lord. I want to invite your attention to Judges chapter number 6. Judges chapter number 6. Let's get into the word of the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Judges chapter number 6, and we will begin reading from verse number 1. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you. If you have it, say amen. If you do not have it, say give me 1 second. Amen. I want us to be on one accord so that God can manifest his power. Amen. Judges chapter number 6, verse number 1. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord. And the Lord delivered them into the hand of the Midianites for 7 years. And the hand of Midian prevailed against Israel. And because of the Midianites, the children of Israel made them dens, which are in the mountains and caves and strongholds. And so it was when Israel had sown their seeds, oh my God,
yes,
that the Midianites came up and the Amalekites and the children of the east, even they came up against them, and they encamped against them, and destroyed the increase, the harvest of the earth, till you come unto Gaza. And they left no sustenance, no food for Israel, neither sheep, nor ox, nor ass. For they came up with their cattle and their tents, and they came as grasshoppers for multitude. For both they and their camels were without number. Somebody say, oh my God. And they entered into the land to destroy it. Somebody say, destroy it.
Destroy it.
And Israel was greatly impoverished because of the Midianites. And the children of Israel cried unto the Lord. Somebody say, cried to God. The children of Israel cried unto the Lord. And it came to pass, when the children of Israel cried unto the Lord because of the Midianites, that the Lord sent a prophet. Oh my God.
All right, man.
The Lord sent a prophet unto the children of Israel, which said unto them, thus said the Lord God of Israel, I brought you up out of Egypt, and brought you forth out of the house of bondage, and I delivered you out of the hand of the Egyptians, and out of the hand of all that oppressed you. And I drove them out from before you and gave you their land. And I said unto you, I am the Lord your God. Fear not the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell, but you have not obeyed my voice. Look at somebody and tell them it's time to get right with God. It's time. It's time to get right with God. You would assume that everybody that's in church is right with God. But I got news for you. Everybody in church is not right with God. He told me to tell you, it is time for you. Who am I talking to today? Let me look right in the white of your eyes. You may be seated.
Amen.
Let me look past your church face and your church outfit. I'm talking to you. God sent me to tell you, it's time. You've been putting it off long enough. You've been procrastinating. How long am I going to fully commit, or am I going to still do my own thing? Can I get a witness? You've been wrestling with God. I know I shouldn't be doing this. Lord, I know that I should walk away from this. But God, it's a struggle.
God, I wish I had a witness.
God, I'm wrestling with your will and with what I like. I'm wrestling with what I hear you calling me to do. But I'm struggling with the stuff that I enjoy. I feel like I'm on a seesaw. I feel, God, I feel like it's pulling me this way and you're pulling me that way. And I'm in the middle struggling with the will of God.
Oh my God.
Struggling with whether or not I'm going to totally surrender to his will or continue to yield to things that I know are displeasing to God. Who am I talking to? Who am I preaching?
Men to struggle. Men to struggle. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord. And the Lord delivered them until the children of Midian for 7 years. I got a word for you today. Are you listening to me? The longer you stay in disobedience, there's going to be some severe consequences for you. Oh my God, the devil is a liar. He will keep you in that situation. He will keep you with that issue, constantly doing evil, constantly doing what you know you shouldn't do, constantly doing what you know isn't right. But he's not showing you the consequences. Oh God. He's not showing you that there are going to be repercussions for what you're doing, and the grace of God is not going to keep you from all the consequences. Yeah. Oh, my shaka. Somebody say, God help me. He's not showing you that when God pours his belt out and begin to chastise you for going in the wrong direction, when God says enough is enough and decides to get the strap out and begin to chastise you for playing with his grace and playing with his will and living a double lifestyle and being a hypocrite and professing to be saved but living a contrary life, the devil is a liar. Do you realize who you're playing with? Do you realize what you're playing with? Tell you there's gonna be consequences for the actions that you're choosing to yield to. There's gonna be consequences. God is a jealous God, and he's not gonna sit back and watch you do whatever you wanna do and let you do it. He loves you too much to watch you go to hell without trying to get you back. Look at your neighbor, say, there's consequences. There's consequences. Are you hearing?
Yes, Lord.
Are you hearing what I'm saying to you?
Yes.
He's not telling you that God's going to remove the hedge of grace and allow you to be chastised for what you have decided to do. He never told you that there are consequences for being a hypocrite.
Come on now!
Oh God! Oh God!
Come on here!
Oh God! Oh God! I feel like I'm talking to somebody here. I feel like God sent me here. I feel like there's somebody in this church right now that I'm talking to. Oh my God, your secret sin. The one that you do and cover it up. The one that you do and you hide it. The one that you do and you refuse to confess it. The one that, who am I talking to here? The one that you do and you refuse to reach out for help. Oh my God, all of this help is available to you in the house of God. The one you don't ask prayer for because you still love it. The one that you don't want deliverance from because it's so good to you. I wish I had a witness. The one that you don't want God to take away. The one that you're holding on to instead of letting it go. Oh, I got news. I got news for you today. God is saying, I'm going to beat your behind. Y'all didn't come here for this, did you? He told me to tell you, you don't let it go. I'm going to pull my strap out. I've given you time to get it right. I've
and say you got the Holy Ghost. Oh my God, come on here. I'm talking about your secret sin, the one you like so much that is wrestling between you and the will of God. God said, I'm gonna punish you. That's two sides to me. Oh God, Lord have mercy. There's two sides. There's two sides to God. There's the goodness of God, but the Bible said that there's the severity of God. We capitalize on the grace and the mercy, but there's also the chastisement. There's also punishment for doing the wrong stuff. There's punishment for going the wrong way. Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord. Oh God, there's consequences for doing evil in God's sight. Woo! I feel it today. There's consequences for going contrary to the will of God. What in the world are you thinking about? What are you doing? You said you a child of God. What in the world are you doing? Getting drunk with your friends. The devil is a liar. God is saying, give it up or else. Give it up or I'm gonna beat you. Oh my God. You think that you're getting away with it, but you're not. Said your sin will find you out. Oh yes it will. Your sin is coming to look for you. I got some consequences to pay you for yielding to me. You wait and see. I got some consequences to pay you for what you're doing in secret. Oh church, God told me to tell you, there is consequence.
Israel never expected for God to turn them over to the Midianites. Did y'all hear what I just said? Israel never expected when they yielded to idolatry and start serving the devil and left God, they did not consider the fact that there would be consequences. Oh God, I'm talking to backsliders here. I didn't say you don't attend church. Oh God, did you hear what I just said to you? You can come to church every scheduled service and still be backslidden. Oh, don't play with me today. You can come to church, but what determines whether you're backslidden or not is what do you do outside of church. Can I get a witness? Oh God, I wish you could do what you want to do and still go to heaven. Oh my God, but it's holiness or hell. Come on here, you either get right or you're going to hell. I'm old school. I believe that you got to live holy to see God in peace. I don't believe you can go to heaven backslidden. Come on here. The Bible said, as a tree falls, so shall it lie. If you die in sin, you're going to hell. Come on, tell somebody. If you die in a backslidden condition, you're going to lift your eyes up in an eternal flame. God sent me today to tell you it's time to get right. Oh my God. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, thank God for repentance.
of. But somebody say, thank God for repentance. I thank God, Pastor, I can apply the blood to wash me and to cleanse me, shun the hell, and purge me from all unrighteousness. He said, if you confess your sin, he can come on shut. Oh God, I feel God in this house. God told me to tell you, if you confess it and put it on the altar, I will forgive you.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I feel it. I feel it in this house. Did you hear what I said? It's not too late. You can put it on the altar. Put it on the altar.
Yes, God.
Yes. But if you don't, there will be consequences.
Come on, Jesus. Thank you for
the
house.
There will be. That goes for me. That goes for the pastor. That goes for you and everybody else.
Amen. That's right.
There will be consequences.
Yes. Yes. Tell it.
You're going to wish to God you hadn't done it. Oh God. When God turned you over to the devil and let the devil have his way with you, because you won't listen to him, because you won't let it go, because you won't give it up, you're going to wish to God never had to yield it to it in the first place. Somebody said, God, deliver me from my